اللہ الرحمن الرحیم وصلی اللہ علی النبی الکریم رب اشرح لی صدری ویسر لی امری واحلل عقدۃ من لسانی یفقہوا قولی. واٹ از اسلام؟ لٹرلی اسلام مینس سرنڈر or submission, but it has no negative connotation. It is completely a positive word. You can say that Islam means to follow a spiritual culture or a divine culture. Islam means to follow a disciplined life, a disciplined life. By discipline I mean divine discipline, divine discipline. So the concept is that man was created by God. Only God knows what is good and what is bad for man. So according to his knowledge, God has sent his prophets and also his books. This book is like a guide, and prophets are like guide for human, for mankind. But there is no compulsion. Man is completely free, completely free. So man is required to adopt divine culture by his own choice, without any compulsion. The concept is that the whole universe, including man, is to follow this divine culture. There is a verse in the Quran in this regard. أَفَغَيْرَ دِينِ اللَّهِ يَبْغُونَ وَلَهُ أَسْلَمَ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ طَوْعًا وَكَرْهًا وَإِلَيْهِ يَرْجِعُونَ. It means that do they want a religion other than Islam? Whereas the whole universe is following this religion, that is Islam or divine culture, willingly or unwillingly. So what the rest of the universe is following unwillingly, that is compulsively, what the rest of the universe is following compulsively, the same is required by man, by choice. Man enjoys freedom. Rest of the universe has no freedom. But culture is the same. Same spiritual culture or divine culture is required by the both, man and the universe. The only difference is that the rest of the universe follows the same divine culture compulsively, and man is required to follow the same divine culture by his own choice. This is the gist of the Islamic concept. Now, I would like to give some example from the Islamic scriptures. Quran says, "An-najmu was-shajaru yasjudan." It means the trees are doing sajda. Trees are performing sajda. Sajda means prostration. So, you know, all the trees are in standing position, but their shadow falls upon earth. This is sajda, prostration. Annajmo vashajaro yasjodan. This is a compulsive form of sajda. And when a man performs namaz and performs sajda in his namaz, that is a sajda by choice. Sajda by choice. So the whole universe is performing sajda. But the rest of the universe performs it by under compulsion, and man is required to do the same sajda by his own choice. This is spiritual culture or divine culture. Then the Quran says, لَشَّمْسُ يَنْبَغِي لَهَا أَن تُدْرِكَ الْقَمْرَ وَلَا اللَّيْلِ سَابِقُ النَّهَارِ كُلُّ فِي فَلَكٍ يَسْبَحُونَ. This Quranic verse tells us that there are numerous stars and planets in the space. All are in moving state, but all the stars or planet are moving in their own orbit strictly. No star or no planet deviates from its orbit. No star or planets interfere in the other orbit. So here you can see that that divine culture, that is submissive culture, is followed by all the stars, all the planets. But this following is under compulsion. The same is required by man. Man should follow the same divine culture, that is non-interference culture. You are free, and you can enjoy your freedom, but you are not allowed to interfere in others' life. So you do this by your own choice. There is a hadith very relevant to this theme. The Prophet of Islam has said, Wallahi la yu'minu, alladhi la ya'manu jaruhu bawa'iqahu. It means that he is not a true mu'min, he is not a true Muslim, who creates problem for others. He is not a true mu'min or Muslim who creates problem for others. Here you can see that the same divine culture is required by man also. You know, every human being, every man and woman are living in society, in a society, among their neighbors. So you are free to enjoy your freedom, but you have no right to interfere in others' life. You are not allowed to create problem for others. Here you can see the same pattern is required by man. All the bodies, all the stars and planets moving in vast space, they are active every time. They move every time. But no star or planet interferes in the life of others. So is required by man. You are active to perform you are free to enjoy your freedom. You are free to launch your activities, but you have to live in your own sphere. You are not allowed to go in the spheres of others. So this is, you can say this is non-interference culture. What I am saying, divine culture or spiritual culture, so it is based on this principle, that is non-interference culture. So you are not allowed to go, you are not allowed to interfere, you are not allowed to interfere in others' life. This is very important. Then there are other examples. Once Prophet of Islam saw a plant, a tender plant in field. So he said that, you see this plant, when some blow of air touches, it bows down. There is no arrogance in this plant. He always live in submission, in compromise, in adjustment. So this plant has adopted the culture of submission, adjustment, and compromise. This is required also by man. What the plant is following by compulsion, because plant has no choice. Plant is following the culture of submission or adjustment or compromise by under compulsion. But same is required by man. Man is also have to live according to this principle. He is not allowed to be arrogant. No. He must adopt the culture of submission, culture of compromise, culture of adjustment. This is also a part of Islam, that is divine culture. Then there is a verse in the Quran. It says that this Quranic verse refers to rain and water. So it says that Wamma Mayan Faud Nas Fam Kosafiller, that rain or water is serving a very important task, that is to be useful for others. That is, in other words, giving culture is universal culture. In this world, everything like rain and water follows the giving culture and not taking culture. Every part of the universe has adopted giver principle rather than taker principle. So is required by man. Man must live in society as a giver member rather than taker member. You have to be useful for others. You have to be useful for others. There is a hadith, it says that, إِلَّمْ تَنْفَاهُ فَلَا تَذُرَّهُ. So there are only two options for human being. Only two options. One, you have to be useful for others. And if you cannot, then you have to save others from your problem, problem harm. إِلَّمْ تَنْفَعُهُ فَلَا تَضُرُّهُ. So either you have to live according to this principle, that you have to be useful for others. And if you cannot, you have no such sources, you're not able to be useful for others, then you have to save yourself from problem, from harms. This is the culture required by Islam. This is also a part of Islamic culture. There is a hadith in this regard. Al-Muslimu man salama an-nasu min lisanihi wa yadihi. Al-Muslimu man salama an-nasu min lisanihi wa yadihi. Muslim is one by whose hands and tongue people are safe. By whose hands and tongue people are safe. Here you can see that what is required by Muslims, a true believer. A true believer is required to live as a harmless person in his society, as a peaceful person in his society. This is the spiritual culture, this is the divine culture, and this is the Islamic culture. So this is the Islamic way of life. This is the Islamic way of life. Then there is a hadith, a companion of the Prophet asked, O Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, allimni kalimatin, aisha bihinna, wala tuksir alayya fansa. O Prophet, give me a master advice by which I may be able to manage all the affairs of my life. The Prophet replied, La taghzab, don't be angry. Now you can see this is the culture of a true Muslim. It means that when there is a provocation, you can understand in advance that a true mu'min is not going to react negatively. La taghzab means don't react negatively. So a Muslim is a predictable character. When there is a provocation, when there is a provocative situation, even then you can foresee in advance the true believer is not going to react negatively. He will forgive. He will adopt the forgive culture rather than reaction culture. So, Muslim is a positive character, always. This is very important. Then, there is a, in Quran, you can find dozens of verses that tell you that adopt sabr culture, استعینوا بالصبر والصلاۃ انما یوفی الصابرون اجرہم بغیر حساب. دیر آر ڈزنز آف ورسز ان دا قرآن دیٹ ٹیل یو دیٹ اڈاپٹ صبر کلچر آلویز ان ایوری سچویشن. صبر مینس پیشنس. نو پیشنس, واٹ از پیشنس؟ پیشنس از ناٹ اے نیگیٹو تھنگ, نو, اٹس کمپلیٹلی اے پازیٹیو بیہیویئر. صبر از اے کمپلیٹلی پازیٹیو بیہیویئر. صبر مینس دیٹ وین یو آر پرووکڈ, وین دیر از سم انپریزنٹ سچویشن, یو ہیو ٹو کیپ پیشنس, یو ہیو ٹو اوائڈ, یو ہیو ٹو اگنور. سو دس از صبر کلچر, اوائڈنس, اگنورنس, فار گیونیس, آل دیز تھنگس آر پارٹ آف صبر کلچر. اینڈ واٹ از صبر کلچر؟ صبر کلچر مینس پازیٹیو کلچر. وین یو بیکم امپیشنٹ دین یو ہیو اڈاپٹڈ نیگیٹو کلچر. ان ایوری ٹائم یو نو ان دس ورلڈ دیر آر انپریزنٹ سچویشن ایوری ٹائم, ایوری ڈے اینڈ نائٹ دیر آر سم پرووکیشن, سم انپریزنٹ سچویشن. سو واٹ ٹو ڈو؟ دیر آر ٹو آپشنس, آئیدر گیو اے پازیٹیو ریسپانس ٹو دا نیگیٹو سچویشنس اور گیو نیگیٹو ریسپانس ٹو نیگیٹو سچویشن. سو دیر از حدیث دیٹ لا تکونوا اماتن. لا تکونوا اماتن مینس ڈونٹ ریسپونڈ نیگیٹیولی ایون ان نیگیٹو سچویشنس, آلویز ریسپونڈ پازیٹیولی. دس از مینشنڈ دا حدیث ان دیز ورڈس, لا تکونوا اماتن. سو دس از دا اسلامک کلچر اور اسپریچوئل کلچر اور ڈیوائن کلچر. ڈیوائن کلچر از بیسڈ آن پازیٹیوٹی. پازیٹیوٹی, پازیٹیوٹی از دا موسٹ امپارٹنٹ آسپیکٹ آف ڈیوائن کلچر. پازیٹیو تھنکنگ, پازیٹیو اسپیچ, پازیٹیو ایکشن, پازیٹیو ایکٹیویٹیز, دیز آر ویری امپارٹنٹ پارٹ آف ڈیوائن کلچر اور اسپریچوئل کلچر. اٹ از دس پازیٹیو کلچر دیٹ از اونلی پرائز آف پیراڈائز. ود آؤٹ اڈاپٹنگ دس کلچر نو ون ول فائنڈ انٹری ان ٹو پیراڈائز, بیکاز قرآن سیز واللہ یدعو الی دار السلام اینڈ گاڈ کالز ٹو دا ہوم آف پیس. ان دس ورس یو کین سی دیٹ پیراڈائز از اے ہاؤس آف پیس, اے لینڈ آف پیس. ان پیراڈائز دا اونلی کلچر ول یو سی دیٹ از پیس کلچر, اسپریچوئل کلچر, پازیٹیو کلچر. سو اونلی دوز پیپل ول فائنڈ انٹری ان ٹو پیراڈائز who proved in this world that they can live on positive culture. They are a positive personality. This is the only criterion, only criterion. Those who proved to be a positive personality, those, you know, every time there are angels, they are engaged in recording. They record our speech and actions. So only those person, only that man or woman will find entry into paradise who proved that in this world is world of test. In this world, they lived a life of positive culture. Their speech was positive speech. Their intentions were positive intentions. Their actions were positive actions. Their activities were positive activities. Only this kind of man or woman are a deserving candidate for paradise. Otherwise not. Then I can say that Prophet has demonstrated this culture in the form of a cow. Cow is a demonstration of divine culture. You know what is cow? Cow is an industry, a divine industry. Cow is able to turn non-milk into milk. Cow is a divine industry, and cow has the ability to turn non-milk into milk. This is required by man also. By man also it is required that he must convert his negativity into positivity. By his own choice. Cow is converting non-milk into milk under compulsion. You know, animals live on their instinct. Rest of the physical world is controlled by law of nature. And animals are controlled by their instinct. But man is quite different. Man is a special creation. Man has choice, man has freedom. So it is required by man to behave like a cow, but by his own choice. Man must convert non-milk into milk by his own choice. Man must convert negative experience into positive one by his own choice. There is a verse in the Quran, وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. When they become angry, they will forgive. When they become angry, they forgive. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. When they become angry, they forgive. Know what it means? It means that a true mu'min is one who is able to convert anger into forgiveness. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. A true believer, a true Muslim, a man who fears God, a man who is candidate of paradise, a man who wants to find entry into paradise, he must follow this culture. He must convert his anger into forgiveness. وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُهُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. You see here, the same culture is required by man. In cow, you see that cow is converting non-milk into milk, grass into milk. The same is required by man. Man must convert his anger into forgiveness. Man must convert his negative thought into positive thought. So this is the divine culture. This is the paradise culture. This is the spiritual culture. And this is Islamic way of life. Only those people who followed this way of life, they will find entry into paradise. Islam is not simply a just set of rituals. No, not simply a set of rituals or reciting some words without understanding its meaning. No, Islam is completely an intellectual activity. Islam is a spiritual culture. Everything in Islam is based on understanding. So Islam is completely an intellectual. Islam is based completely on intellectual activities. Everything. You can find the details of this divine culture or spiritual culture in Quran and Hadith. In Quran, you can find the basics of this culture. Basics. If you read Quran, you will find in Quran the basics of this divine culture. Then in Hadith, you can find the details of this divine culture. So in Quran and Hadith, you can find the whole picture of divine culture or spiritual culture. So this is the concept of paradise in Islam. Paradise is for those who have adopted this culture. Paradise is not simply a birth. No one will find paradise as a birth, as a birthright. No. Paradise is only for those men or women who follow this positive culture that is based on sabr, on patience, on forgiveness, on tolerance. Then also love is a part of this divine culture. Love, compassion is also a part of this divine culture. The Prophet of Islam used to rise early in the morning. Then he say after his morning prayer, Allahumma shahad anna al-ibad kulluhum ikhwa. O God, I bear witness that all men and women are brothers and sisters to each other. The essence of his dua is love, compassion. It means that the whole world is divine family. Every man is your brother, and every woman is your sister. This is divine culture, this is spiritual culture. You have to find love in your heart for every human being. You have to be compassionate for every human being. So love is a part of divine culture. Love and compassion, an integral part of divine culture. You see, when you take a Quran, a copy of the Quran, and open it, you'll find that the very first verse is like this, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. You know, this verse is repeated in the Quran no less than 114 times. This verse introduces God as a Ar-Rahim and Ar-Rahman. merciful and compassionate. So God is merciful to all and compassionate to all. Then there is a hadith, takhallaqu bi akhlaqillah, adopt divine character. Takhallaqu bi akhlaqillah, adopt divine character. Now, what is divine character? It is based on Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. So Rahmat is a divine culture. So you have to adopt Rahmat culture, culture of compassion, culture of mercy. This is the Rahmat, this is the divine culture, and this is Rahmat culture. And every Muslim must adopt this culture. Every Muslim must be Ar-Rahim and Ar-Rahman, like God. تَخَلَّقُوا بِأَخْلَاقِ اللَّهِ. So it is must for every man and every woman to be compassionate for others, to be well-wisher for others. There is a hadith, the Prophet of Islam has said, عَاشِرِ النَّاسَ بِخُلُقٍ حَسَنٍ. It means that be compassionate to all human beings. Be well-wisher to all human beings. In other words, you can say that everyone must adopt the culture of compassion or human-friendly culture, insan-friendly culture or human-friendly culture. Islamic culture is human friendly culture. But you know, it is not a very simple formula. It requires patience. Because when you are living in a society where every time there are negative experiences, there is no ideal society in this world. Ideal society cannot be established. In every society, there are conditions less than ideal. So in every society, you always experience negativity. So to be compassionate to all requires to be patient, forgiveness, without adopting sabr culture, you cannot be passionate to all. You cannot adopting sabr culture, you cannot adopt human friendly culture. The gist of Islam is that you have to live as a well-wisher to all. But it also requires to be patient, to be positive, because our society is not an ideal society. Ideal society is impossible. Everything here is less than ideal. Every time there are provocation, every time there are negative experiences. So if God says that you have to be compassionate, it is implicit in this commandment that you have to be patient. You have to adopt sabr. So compassion means unilateral adjustment. Compassion and love require unilateral adjustment. Prophet Isa said, love your enemy. It means that without love culture, You cannot be compassionate with your enemy. So this is the Islamic culture. And those who adopt this Islamic culture, they will find entry into paradise. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم أجمعين.